Hi guys, what we're looking at here is a digital clockwork kit that I assembled back in 2016. It came up in conversation today on YouTube with my YouTube pal Mike Flight, and I was saying how one of the first things that went wrong with it was some of the green LEDs failed. You might see that the green is stepping around. It's supposed to indicate the minutes, but you'll see there's quite a few of them quite simply aren't working, and some of them are a bit dull. Now, I'm not entirely sure whether that's a component fault, as in something on the back here at fault, or whether it's just the LEDs have died. So what I might do is desolder one of the ones that clearly isn't working and put another one on top of it or in its place. I suppose I could just try and put an LED straight on the back. I'm sure when I finished it initially, it all worked. So it's all surface mount components. There's a whole load of little transistors here. So it could be a dry joint on one of them, driving the LEDs. But I am sure that they all worked initially. Right, me doing that has just upset it because I've shorted a few things out. Let's reset it. Okay, so the red are the hours and the green the minutes. Over here somewhere we are at the moment. Yeah. So there is quite a few that are not working. Have I just fixed it? No. But it did look like when I touched something over here, a few more of them came on than were coming on before. That does make me think it might be a dry joint in there. I'll have a closer look. So I'm sure that just touching there, I've got more to come on. One of the settings. No, that's resetting the time. I don't want that. Ah, right, that's a different setting. Right, that's just a single one goes out when the time goes round. There's still clearly some missing. clearly did something, didn't it? Reset. I touched something over here. Right, that's an alarm. That's a capacitor I shorted out. Yeah, that's what happened there. I shorted out C4 with my finger. This is not a technical way of fault finding by any means. But if there's a loose joint, me pushing it, reset again. Now we've definitely got some dead over here, haven't we? Right, what I'll do is I'll get some LEDs and I'll just put them on the back of these and see if they light up. Right, box of LEDs. Got some nice little green ones here. So what I need to do is go across the back. Which way round are they? That way. Right, we're not alight there. Let's put it on the back of one that does light up. Must be doing it the wrong way around. Right, that one's alight. Right, that one lights up if I go on the back of it. Oh. That one just lit up for a second then. Sure it did. Right. LED on the back of that one. It's dead on that side, a light on that side. Next one. Yeah. So it does look like it's actually the LEDs are dead. Try and move them and see if might be worth trying to put a soldering iron on the back of it and just see if that improves it, because that one's come on now that I've wobbled it around a bit. So it's either the soldering looks absolutely fine, that looks spot on. So I think it's more likely it's actually the LEDs are failing inside. Yeah, clearly if I wobble it around a bit. I don't know if you're actually seeing this, but I reckon it's actually the LEDs themselves are failing. It's not the solder joint. I will run a soldering iron over the back of them again just to check, but I'm sure that's what it is. It's not the solder joint. I think it's actually the LED, the component parts of it are out of alignment somehow. Right, find one that's not working. Well, that one started working again now. Right, that one, if I push on it, it starts lighting up. So we will check it's not a soldering issue. It's a light. Okay, so if that made a difference, let's try this one. It was light for a minute. Could be because I'm soldering on it when it's live, we're getting some sort of capacitance off the soldering iron. Well, it looks to me like it's the soldering that's failed. reset it a second. Those two started working just now and they've stopped again. Suppose what I should do, now that I've got a 3D printer, is make a proper stand for it so we're not using blue tack to hold it all together. Right, those have stopped working again. They were working just then. Or were they? Or am I just out of position? Nope, they were ones that weren't working. Reset. It's almost like I'm drying them out. Weird. If I hold it on there for a while, it seems to... It worked for a second and then it died. I still think it's the LEDs that are actually at fault. And I think because I'm heating them up to resolder them, they're actually realigning themselves. That sounds a bit far-fetched, but I'm sure that's all it is. Just these two left. See what I've just done there. Just that one. Yeah, I can see what it is now, all that effort. It is, the LED is falling apart. Let's disconnect that for a minute. Yeah, I was right from the beginning. It is the LEDs that are failing, not my soldering. My re-soldering was just allowing the metal parts to reset within the plastic casing and getting them to realign so they were actually working. My soldering was fine. Just work that one back through. Let's unplug it again. Right, that's 36 minutes so far. I've only replaced one LED, but I think the problem was they were rubbish LEDs. And when I was re-soldering them, because I thought it might have been the solder joints were poor, just by putting pressure on the top of the LED, it was actually getting it to go again. So it's actually realigning the little metal components within the LED, getting them to light up. So the only one that I've replaced is the one that's got the legs sticking out the back here. So I'll cut them off properly and that will be job done. I won't try and replace all the other LEDs because that'll just take a ridiculous amount of time. But that's it. They were rubbish LEDs.
Thanks for watching. If you want more information, check down below in the video description. If you like this video, you might like this one up here. And if you want to subscribe, you can check out my channel over here. Up here is my latest video on my channel, and down here is a video playlist associated with the video you've just watched. Thanks again for watching.